I mean, look, Amazon, we know, is the largest cloud provider with almost 50% share. And when it comes to the GPUs, everyone so far except for Google has relied on Nvidia, you know, for training. And what Amazon is doing is really copying that Google playbook where they want to use their own chips. It's just that they haven't had that kind of success that Google has had with TPUs, and they're trying to speed things up because in the end, all these hyperscalers don't want to spend, you know, 20 to 25% of their CapEx on procuring Nvidia's chips. And that is what the end game is. I think Google so far is ahead in that, but clearly Amazon is trying to catch up when it comes to their own chips efforts.
Mandeep, it feels like Amazon, Google are becoming more formidable competitors to Nvidia in this space, Nvidia the AI darling. When you think about 2026, who are some of the winners in this AI arms race?
I mean, look, when you're running a cloud business, you know, you're trying to optimize things across the stack. And that's where, you know, a Meta is very different from a Google or an Amazon, which have a big public cloud business. I think what you're going to see is focus more on CapEx efficiency. If Google can deliver, you know, a lot more with their $90 billion in CapEx in terms of training, inferencing, and having a cloud business, everyone will be measured the same way, whether it's Amazon or Meta. And that's where CapEx efficiency will be a much bigger focus in 2026 than it was in the past 2 years where, you know, there was a gold rush going on in terms of getting these GPUs, making sure you have chips for training your models. I think we are moving into a phase where CapEx efficiency will be front and center going forward.
Mandeep, I see a Bloomberg News story. Apple AI head to leave. This doesn't feel right to me. What's going on with Apple and AI? And am I reading too much into this? It seems like there's a lot of turnover there.
I mean, look, for a good reason, because Apple, when you think about the Mag 7 players, has trailed in terms of having an AI strategy, making those investments. And right now we are seeing even, you know, just yesterday, DeepSeek released their latest model. ByteDance is talking about a model that can be run on your operating system. So there is so much going on at the hardware and at the operating system layer that you feel like Apple is missing out, one, because they don't have any AI models of their own. And also in terms of their partnerships, they haven't been that upfront about, you know, whether it's OpenAI or Google in terms of making changes to their operating system. So even though the hardware sales haven't really suffered because of that, I mean, when you look 2 years out, if Apple doesn't have a good AI strategy, a good model that works natively on the operating system, I think you will start to see an impact on the hardware sales.